It's the first time I've ever seen a cow like that. It's weird.
Morning, everybody. You are watching Echowood Holsteins and YouTube channel, and we're just taking care of cows this morning. We got some different things we got to do, so just thought we would take a video and show you what we're up to these days. Jaron's home from school.
Yeah.
Because of a COVID rule, he doesn't have COVID, but kind of exposed to it. So he's around, and we're just gonna show you. We got some worming to do. And we've got a cow we're gonna take care of right out here. A fresh cow, we need to pump her and give her some calcium because she hasn't cleaned yet and she's cold. And we got pre-fresh cows to move into the dry cow pen, and we're gonna explain about that. So we'll be seeing you around. So we got this cow here, number 1323. And she calved overnight and she still hasn't cleaned, which means the placenta that the calf was wrapped in, you can see it here hanging out of her. And she's actually kind of cold, and you feel her body and her ears are cold. So we're gonna give her calcium and we're gonna pump her with warm water and try to get that cleaning out. And Cassie's gonna help us do that. This is Cassie. She's helping with the calves and helping with a lot of the health related things on the cows. So she's actually learning a lot. Or maybe she already knows, but just teaching how we do it here.
Yep.
And she's doing really good. So first thing we're gonna do is fill this. We're gonna put about 10 to 15 gallons of warm water in this jug here, and we're gonna pump the cow, pump it down into her stomach, and we're also gonna give her a calcium pill. So, Jared, you wanna get that calcium pill out? You can give her that. And I'm gonna get, we put this in their throat. And then we put a hose in there. Let's see if I can put you here on this post. Actually, Cassie, could you hold this? And just show what we're doing.
Okay.
You're gonna, okay.
You do it first. And then I'll do this.
Let's save this, let's pump her first, right, and then we'll put that in afterwards. So basically this is just a pipe that goes in so that the hose, you can stick the hose in there without her biting the hose and chewing a hole in the hose. So we put that in her throat, and then you put the halter on her. Because if she swings her head around and hits you with this thing, it's gonna hurt. Okay.
Yeah.
So let me stick this hose into her stomach, or down her throat, and it can go two ways, just like people. It can either go in the stomach or it can go in the lungs. So we got to make sure we got it in the stomach. This is called pumping the cow. So a lot of times you can smell the stomach gas, or I can't smell it. I probably could if I blow on it and let it come back. But Jaron is back here and I'm going to blow in the hose, and he's going to hear like a rushing sound of air. So ready, Jaron?
Yeah. I'm good.
Did you hear it?
Yep.
Okay, and now I smell it. I blew air in and now I can smell like nasty gas coming out. So we know what's in her stomach. So then this is basically a fertilizer pump. Okay. We got a little too much in there.
Yeah.
So let's drain some out. This holds about 30 gallons, and right now we got about 20 in there, which is too much, because if you give them too much water after they're freshen, they can actually push their uterus out. We've had it happen before, so we try to limit it to about 10 to 15 gallons. They can push their uterus out anyhow, but it seems more likely if you overdo it on the water. But this is really good for them. It's warm. And then we put fresh cow mix in there. If you want to go get that? A couple of YMCP.
YMCP, yeah.
Okay. got a YMC product, a product called YMCP that we just dumped in. And now we got the agitation, we got an agitation valve here. So it's stirring. And the valve for the cow is off, so it's not going under yet. So now that it's stirred up, we'll slow it down. And I'm gonna turn the agitation off and open the valve up, so now it's going into it. You just want to be careful that sometimes the hose wants to work out of the throat, and you don't want that to happen, because if it will come out and then she can't swallow fast enough, it could get into her lungs, and then you got bigger problems. Really big problems. Like, this cow's ears, her ears are cold, and that's one way to know that a fresh cow needs calcium. Just, like, they're not ice cold, but they're really cool. They're not warm like they should be. And she didn't clean, so that's another indication that maybe she needs calcium. Okay.
Almost.
Now when you're done, we just unhook the hose, and it would pretty much siphon out of there a lot of times because she's got a lot of water in her. So you just put your finger over the end so it can't siphon and it won't drain out the other end, and then you pull it out so that you don't get water going back in the lungs. And now our hose is full. We'll just dump that out. And then Jaren's gonna give her calcium pill.
Yeah,
it's good. Yep. So now Jaren's gonna give her a calcium pill, and then we can let her loose. Okay, so now we are gonna move cows from our dry cow pen to our pre-fresh pen. And the reason, basically a dry cow is a cow that is not giving any milk, she's dry basically. And the reason that they would be dry and that you would still have them is because they're pregnant and they're gonna have a calf. And you give them a 60 day break
in between calves, basically a 60 day vacation before they have their baby.
So this right here, this is our dry cow pen.
And you can see there's quite a few cows in here. And then 3 weeks before they calve,
we take and we move them over here into our pre-fresh pen.
So we just gotta open up either that gate or this gate right here in between the pens and sort out the ones that we need to put in the pre-fresh.
Now, the reason that there is a pre-fresh group is basically to acclimate the cow's body to get used to get ready to have a baby. And the dry cow ration will go up here by the feed.
This dry cow feed, there's a lot of straw in here. There's like 9.5 pounds of straw per cow. Just, and straw has not much nutritional value, but you don't want the cows gaining weight in the dry cow pen, so it's just kind of like a maintenance diet, and because they don't need much energy.
You're basically just giving them enough energy to survive or maintain. You don't want them losing weight, you don't want them gaining weight. Well, then 3 weeks before they have the baby, you move them into the pre-fresh group,
which would be this pen right here. So we were over here in the dry cows. We're gonna move them to the pre-fresh, and this is the pre-fresh feed. And this looks really similar
to the feed
from the dry cows, but it does have more energy and more protein, and it's got something called anionic salts in it. And the salts, basically, the salts that the cows are consuming, they make the, they just get the cow's body able to absorb calcium out of their bones and their muscles after they have a calf, so that you don't end up with the cow that we just pumped because she was low in calcium. It's called milk fever. When they're low in calcium, basically they got milk fever. She's got a mild case of milk fever because she's still up. She's just a little cold. She hasn't passed her placenta yet. So just a mild case. In a severe case, the cow won't be able to get up. They're pretty much be paralyzed from the lack of calcium, and you'll have to supplement calcium. We're feeding these salts from Fibro. They basically allow the cow to do that naturally. A bigger percentage of the cows will sail right through calving, and they'll have the baby, they'll start eating
the milk cow mix, and they'll just be ready to rock and roll and have a good lactation,
you know, or a good year making milk and just being healthy
and everything else.
As soon as they would have the baby, they would go onto this mix.
And this is our milk cow mix. And this is definitely a lot higher energy
and more protein and everything a cow needs to make a lot of milk. So it's too much of a change
to take them from the dry cow feed way down there in the end to this milk cow feed right here. So the pre-fresh is like a good transition feed. And they're in here for about 3 weeks, and then they go to this milk cow feed. So that's kind of the down and dirty of
why the three different groups. And we're gonna go sort some cows out of the pre-fresh group. We're gonna go sort some cows out of the dry cow group into the pre-fresh now. And we'll show you the list we got and how we keep track of that.
I think we need a list.
Why?
Because I only found the last marking from 17.
Okay, so do you know how many cows we have in that pre-fresh group?
23.
You counted them?
23.
Okay.
So Jaren says there's 23 cows in there. Normally we try to put 29 in there. But right now we have heavy calving. We are going up to 34 cows. So we got 23 in there?
Mm-hmm.
We need another
11.
11 more. And how many do we have here?
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Okay, so we got enough on this list. So basically, this is their calving date, expected calving date. So you go off of this, and so this cow is due on 2-2, February 2nd. So it is the middle of January. We got to get that cow into the pre-fresh. So we're going to move from 1158 down 11 cows, and I think it'd be 1691 would be the last one that we're going to move. So if you want to write them all on the paper,
yeah,
just write them neatly on the back of here so we know who we need. We'll get ready to move them.
Okay, so we got our list made. We're going to go sort these cows out and show you how we do that.
We need one more.
Huh?
We need one more.
You want me to make another one?
Sure.
Okay, let's go sort them.
Yep.
So basically, is how we're doing this.
We put a gate across on the end of the pen,
and then I'm going to start, me and Jaren are going to start on this side of the pen.
And we're gonna go all the way down the pen, and we're gonna take any cow that's on this list, we're gonna take them around with us. That's just, we try to keep the cows calm, so they'll sort a lot better if we stay calm. If we stay calm, the cows will stay calm, right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
And then Cassie is sorting them into the pre-fresh down here as they come around.
So we found a cow already, we need her. She's in the dry cow pen. She's got to get in the pre-fresh pen. So we'll just sort her right now. Here's another one right there. 1512. So we got 1512, those two right there done. And just gotta sort a few more.
Okay, no 1700.
Great.
Good. I don't know who this is. This one, I would think. See how this cow's starting to bag up? She's getting pretty close to calving. She's getting a lot of swelling. That's actually a first calf heifer. She is on our list. That's 1155.
Yeah. So now I'm going to help Cassie sort a couple. Oh, here's one. Actually, her.
Okay.
Yeah, 1163. Yep.
Yep.
1159.
How about this heifer?
1159. Yep.
1159. Yep. Need her. Need all three of these. We can let it go.
No clue how many we got.
951 just went in.
Alright. Yeah. We got one left. She's right up here. Calf laying right there.
So we got them all into the pre-fresh now.
11 of them. Cassie did good for her first time. And another thing kind of to talk about, it'd be, so the pre-fresh group is the group that you really don't want to have too many cows in the pen.
I mean, you want to have enough feed space for the cows to eat, and you want it to be very low stress. And that's why we keep a close eye on how many we put in here and why we normally put 29. And like I said, now we're putting up to 34, but they're calving so fast, it'll only be 34 for day, who knows? Maybe they'll be four fresh today, but I see there's, actually they were down to 33 already because there's a heifer that just had a baby in here. So, but you just want it low stress. You want plenty of bunk space. You want at least 30 inches, I believe, is the
recommended bunk space on pre-fresh, maybe even 36. But I don't remember what it was, but for 29 cows, that's plenty of room. But like I say, we're pushing it right now, but we just got so many calving, it's our only choice. So, besides selling cows. And who would sell cows?
So then the last part of moving the pre-fresh would be coming into the room here
and marking off all the cows that we just moved. See, this cow was already in. She freshened early. How far down here did we go, Jared? 1163?
Yeah.
Okay. So then we write down what date we moved them in. It is the
17th.
And the next time we move cows, we start with these two. And then we're gonna need new paper, you said?
Oh no, I didn't see that paper yet. I see the paper.
Oh yeah, before. There's another. Yeah.
Okay. So that'll be to everybody for this video. That cow didn't clean. Dad's over there treating her, giving her a little bit more calcium. We still have heifers to go yet. Some heifers. We did a couple ready heifers, some over there. But all the cows, that barn and then the barn over there, they're all done. So we thank you guys for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one.
Crazy.
Different. She's different.